Hello, welcome back to the Dissident here at Caffeinated Gaming. It's Friday, yeah, that's right, Friday. And that means that for today, it's time to screw around, and today I'm screwing around with my d20 and 20 decks. Let's find that right. I actually had to delete my limited deck I did with WW Knight a week or two back, because I got 21. Three! Oh man, the big dragon. I wonder if I can get a game going with Hyper. I'll try it. Oops, that's merged. Let's go for it. See if I can get a Hyper game. Also, someone warned me about Company Heroes 2. I can't find any info about it. I'm not a fan of games that have NDAs when you can get in the beta from a pre-order or some other easy way. But just on the safe side, I'm not going to post the video after all. Just, I don't want to get my account in trouble, and I don't want to get my Steam account or Relic or whatever it is account in trouble. But I do want to rant a little. I hate it when games do that. If you can get guaranteed access to a quote-unquote beta from a pre-order, anyone could potentially get access to the game and see the game. You're only limiting it so people buy their money first. That, I don't know. When it gets to the point where you're thinking it's basically a demo, if you're not confident in your demo to show it off, then don't. Then don't let people in. I don't know. But that's not the first game that's happened, and it's probably not going to be the last one. I'm going to have to play this on normal speed. Not good. But I'm not going to post a video just to be on the safe side. I probably will do some Darkfall, though. And I'll warn you, I'm not good at shooters, and Darkfall, as a mage, is essentially an RPG shooter. Yeah, it's not going to work too well. But I did want to show it because I know the original game was quite popular, and it just had some issues at launch, like you couldn't make an account. In fact, at one point I may or may not have bought an account and tried the game out for 5 minutes, go, not for me, and then sold it because it was so hard to create an account then. But the new Darkfall is out, and I was messing with it last night. I will also say more, it is a subscription game, so I personally will probably only play it for a month. I was just curious, so. And at some point, some Defiance, I was going to do it last night, but last night was board game night, which means I went to the local game store and played some Ascension, and I think it was called Outbreak was the other one. But the new set of Ascension's kind of cool. I don't know if it's quote-unquote balanced yet, but the whole energized mechanic is really cool. So if you're a fan of deck-building games, you might want to check that one out, because that one, the energized mechanic, is kind of changes the way the game works a little bit. Looks like I got no choice in the matter. Oh boy. Join multiplayer. This is not the deck for standard speed. If I'm facing against Flamed on and normal speed, I've lost. That's pretty much all there is to it. If I get control deck, I might have a good chance. I don't know. I also, a lot of my decks I have not updated since we got Firebolts. And since there's a couple other changes, like Assassinate being nerfed. And heck, there's a couple that are from around when Wealthy Nobles didn't cost you 5 morale. I'm not going to tweak my decks too much until we start seeing new cards, and until apparently there's a pretty big balance and bug fix change coming. So you keep promising, JJJ, I'm going to hold you to it. Alright, I'll come back when I get the game going, because there's just no end start despite six people being on. Alright, here. Warhawk. Well, so I lose, and we'll do game two after this. Looks like we're facing it off against a Flame Dawn with Sage 1 support. And I'm playing a deck that is just for fun and was meant kind of with the idea of playing Hyper. I'm just going to see if I can survive the initial onslaught. Probably not, because he's going to Sage 1 now. And yep. Yup. This is what happens when we play decks for fun. Sometimes you regret it. At least I'm going to kill that thing. And I'm going to guess you're going to bring this out to hit me, kill my guy. No, you're not. I'm going to balanced warrior. That kind of works out for me. And activate. There it goes. I used to bug out sometimes like that. If you'd click and it wouldn't go away, then it stuck with you the whole game. Assassinate my dragon. Why would you do that? Well, that's what the deck is based on. But it works better in hyper. That's why I said this is a hyper deck. Because I can do that in turn 3. It's actually a little bit more defensive of a Flame Dawn deck than I'm used to. Warhawk. I'm used to basically almost pure Flame Dawn with just Sage 1. Alright. We'll do that. Let's do exactly that. After this, I could probably bring up my Great Wall. Not that it matters. Alright. He's still got that friggin' Murder Golem. So what I'm gonna do is Shikana, eat the big hit this turn. I can't do anything about it. That's pretty much it. I wonder. I could test that theory. Can Shikana sacrifice the dragon? They're going to sit there the whole game, and all I think it does is just give me 2 extra cards a turn. I need to test that in an AI game now, because I'm going to end this game just because I don't think I can win, but I need to test that. That's kind of a cool idea. I wonder if it works. Well, I don't think I'm going to be able to this turn. I think I'll have to say no anyway. Because I want to... just in case he decides to get ballsy. So I'm going to do that anyway. Do I have any way of dealing with the Murder Golem this turn? Play one of my own. That's how I'm going to deal with it. Alright, make you back up, and next turn I might actually have my Martyr Golem in play. Or not my Martyr Golem. Herp. My Dragon of Wisdom. I do. And on top of that, I got a Rallying General. And oops, crap. Oh well. Ooh, in that case, I can do that just to reduce your output a little bit. See what Warhawk's got planned. Some sort of death spell so I can't block and then kill me. Could be a stumble. Stumble would be a pretty good way to deal with this. Probably could stumble me and kill me this turn, in fact. And he thought, looks like he just discarded a Burning Prejudice. There we go. That card is so cheap mana resource wise. Alright, that burns everyone for three, so you're dead. You're dead. You have initiative. Ugh. Gotta reburn them because he's gonna Sage 2 or Sage 1. And Martyr Golem. I lose! Yay! I knew I'd lose when I played this deck, though. Darn you, die! Why'd you make me play this deck against the Flame Dawn deck? Alright, come on, d20, do better. I'm gonna replace you with another d20. I got a 1. That's that deck. Alright, see if this one works out any better. I should cancel and wait a minute. Wait for Warhawk to get in the game, because I'm not playing that deck again. Good game. You did beat me. So, I'll be back when I get another game. Just going to wait for Warhawk to get another game, because if I'm playing for fun, I can't play Flame Dawn. Especially, if I remember right, this is not a good Flame Dawn deck, too. So, I'll be back when I get a hand. Alright, just for anyone who's curious, if you sacrifice Dragon of Wisdom to Shekana, it does go in the graveyard, or wherever it's called. It does not stay in play, so you don't get to sack it. You have to actually have it killed. So, just a little, I figured I'd test it, so I noticed that. And alright, back to the deck I had rolled, and see what happens. Instant? No, I'll be back. Alright, welcome back. Got a tri-faction deck with Titanitis. Probably going to be Flame Dawn with Control and Support. So let's just see what I can do against it. Ah, no. Activate that. I always seem to be forgetting that. Now that I'm not playing Varroa very often, I keep forgetting to use Gluttony when I actually think about when I'm getting to it. Hard to hinder. Not that I ever mispronounce anything, Deimos. Yes, I do. That's a turn. And now for him to Lightning Blast me. I'm going to say no this turn because I'm going to hit at least... I'm going to hit something, damn it. I'm going to Extended Operate you. Extended Operations. Now you're going to Lightning Blast me. There you go. You eat that. Start that action going. I can get behind this. See what you got planned for me now, Titanitis. Now that guy should be, what, 5-5? Of course it doesn't kill him. Does kill Rodaria? Rodaria? Come on, I want to click on her, damn it. Rodaria. Well, I killed her, whatever her name is. Yeah, I'm gonna do that so I can kill him. Oh, we're gonna race. That's probably good for you. Oh. Let's try that. Alright, you got a 5-8. I'm just gonna draw a card and end my turn, I think. Here. Everyone can have a heat wave. Well, crap. And now for the death ray, and then I lose. Right? Is that the plan here, Tynetus? Like, you're gonna death ray my gluttony, and then... Do you have blue? No, you don't have blue, so you can't anti-air missile. You get death ray, you could stumble, exhaust. You could back off and wait for what you want. Two, six will hit you, and one. All right, now you've had another card to draw. Do you have your answer yet? He's only pulled two of them so far, and there's probably, what, 12 in his deck? I'm gonna just throw that out. Actually, I think I'm gonna do this. I'll put him in backup just in case. Oh well. Oh, you can't even eat when you're exhausted at all, huh? Well, right right now, what I'm basically waiting for is the Calamity to come out. So that's why I'm going to sit back and try to pump out a token with my thing. I think I'll leave it at 2 charges in case. In case I need to go for the 3rd charge for some reason. End turn. No, of course. I just realized I just sacrificed both my things. And now he's got a much bigger hand than me, so he's probably in good shape. Not sure quite how I can win other than just holding on and seeing if I can make something happen. That could work. Problems, I have to keep him in defense for so long right now. Is he drawing cards again? Draw. Back up. Am I actually going to do damage to you, Titanitis? Am I actually going to do damage? No, I'm not. True Calamity. It does make it really hard to come back from a game where you're down with Calamity, because I come back, I'm, you know, he's winning, he can stop playing cards because he can just kind of ride his lead and be stocking up for Calamity. I have to keep pushing up to catch up, and then I lose everything when the Calamity comes out. It makes it really hard to catch up. But I don't think I'm ready to Calamity him back. Do that, and then I'm gonna explore. I'm gonna have to end up blowing up my own event is a problem. Alright. One. You will start getting bigger because I need you to be. That's all the attacking, at least. I'm running out of time. I'm not going to play the Wealthy Noble because I really can't afford to lose another 5 morale. Not when I'm losing 2 a turn already. Actually, we'll just do it this way. And I'm going to cleanse my own thing off now. Ending drone. Darn it. Whoa, buddy. Loud ass ringtone. I actually hit him once, so look at that. Down to 42. This was the weirdest hand ever. But I will say that's probably the one thing about Calamities. It's basically almost impossible to come back when you're losing when that happens, because an opponent can just sit back and say, now you gotta approach me, and then when you do that, then I can go ahead and kill you. And you can see Titanus is being very smart and not overcommitting. Oh, man. Oh, come on! Boo, bug. After that long-ass game, it's going to come down to desyncing. Or whatever that was. Oh well, maybe it showed him that I was out of morale even though I had one left. 8. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Well, I played it yesterday, but I don't care. I want to play it again. If you can't beat him, join him. Flame Dawn it is. So stay tuned for their game. Alright, welcome back. Game 3. It looks like me and Titanitus are both going to cheese it up this hand. So let's get in the game and get going. End turn. Yeah. I don't have any of those fancy schmancy Flame Dawn aspirins in this deck. Now I'll just smack you. And we're going to exhaust Kali. The ultimate speed deck. And now Kali's gonna go and kill everybody. Actually, no, he's gonna put his Kali first. So this is probably a bad move. No, damn it! I'm trying to fix it. I'll fight you too. Stumble. Yeah, stumble. Exhaust you. Alright, let's see your Agent Coil. Not that I called it, but I mean, it's kind of what you'd expect. Now it's my turn. Alright, so we'll assassinate you and stumble you. Let's see your coil. You got two of them? Yep. Assassinate, and I think I'm actually going to leave it like that. What are things you can do? Not too many. I'm not going to have any mana or resources is the one problem, but I'm going to need it. Other problem is, of course, he's got all his cards left, so he can keep dropping crap on me. I just got a little control left. You kill that, and you kill that. So all he needs is two aspirants, another, what's it, Call the Crusade? Yeah. Oh, that'll do. Good game. I'm 0 for 3 today. The dice, they have failed me. Well, that's it for the week for Infinity Wars. Thanks for watching, and I'll probably try and do some other games today. Probably a little bit Defiance. I don't know what I want to do with it. I just wanted to gauge how people thought of the premiere. And also a little bit of Darkfall. I just want to look at the game in a little bit. $40 price tag, $15 a month. That seems a little rough nowadays, but we'll have to see. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned to more. See you next week. Oh, and have a good weekend. Yeah, that.